This is the WHTC Morning News with Gary Stevens and Peg McNichol on 99.7, 1450 WHTC and WHTC.com.
Back to the WHTC Morning News for this Friday, December the 10th, second Friday of the month at this time. City Hall Chatter focuses on Holland City Hall with one of its elected leaders. And today we are joined by Holland City Council member Nikki Arendshorst via the Zoom connection this morning. Nikki, good morning and Merry Christmas to you and your family.
Same to you.
First of all, it's a festive time of year, and obviously Holland is looking pretty nice. I would assume City Council likes the way that the lights are set up and all the decorations are up, and kudos to the Holland Board of Public Works for making it look very festive right now.
Yeah, I agree. It's beautiful, and it's busy, and people seem to be enjoying it also.
Speaking about downtown Holland especially, certainly some fees have to go up. It's a nature of the beast. Fees for snow melts, fees for parking, for downtown businesses and residents as well. You try to keep the numbers down, but you know, like everything else, you know, prices go up. And you know, unlike other entities that can maybe take things at a loss, you know, the municipal government, they got to, you know, have the books balanced. And unfortunately, some of the extra expenses have to be passed along.
That's exactly right. And we will be considering those expenses. The staff will present the budget next month. Then we have to think of what we get, the value we get for our money. So we like our downtown. There are amenities. People enjoy it. Sometimes the burden does fall on individual shop owners or people, residents. But the city, you know, it's a group thing. And we do get a value for what we invest.
All right. I'm going to ask you a question. And you mentioned the word budget, Nikki. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the budget making process begins in earnest next month with the two coffees with council and ends on the first meeting in May by the council when they vote on the spending plan for what will be fiscal 2023 next year. Stepping aside as a council member to become Nikki Arendshorst, the citizen. If you were a citizen and you were going to maybe one of those coffees with council next month, what would you be telling city council members that you would like to see done in 2022-23?
That's a good question because, of course, I can't separate the two very well. I will say, stop this service. And I'm told, you know, there are certain things that people insist on having. And one is leaf pickup in the fall. Another thing is, oddly enough, the calendar that comes out, the yearly calendar. And I would say you can cut down or, you know, somehow, if not eliminate, do something with those. But those are services people expect. I'm not sure. I would invest more in perhaps looking at so we have a new traffic light at 12th and River now, and I would think about having crosswalks further down Washington. There are some apartment buildings closer to 40th and Washington. A lot of people live there, and it's to me there needs to be extra safety measures there. That's what I would think about pedestrian. We are a car-centric city, a car-centric country. Let's think about pedestrians.
So, yeah, I'm just, you know, again, these are what reason why I put it the question of you as a citizen instead of a council member, because sometimes, and I think I'm going to say this to all the council members as well. Sometimes you got to step aside out of the office for a minute. Yes, you might have inside knowledge in certain things, but maybe by thinking what the public might be thinking gives you a fresh idea about some of the things that need to be done.
Yes, and public is very concerned about safety. They're concerned about noise, speeding cars, as we all are, as I am, just as a citizen. So those are things that affect me. I like the downtown. I like the different varieties of vendors. I like my city services. I really like my taxes, which are coming this month. But again, there's your value.
So now, now let me add something that when we had Keith Van Beek, this Holland City Manager, on Talk of the Town last Thursday, a caller had asked him about maybe the city doing something to improve the image or the visual view of especially those entering the Eastern Gateway area, Chicago Drive, 8th Street, into the Holland area. Some of the views aren't really the most flattering of the Tulip City. And while many of the properties that the caller was concerned about are private properties and, you know, and also their township properties as well, it does lead to the question, Nikki, though, of how does this city look for those who may be driving in through its major entrances, be it Washington Avenue or M40 Lincoln Avenue on the south side, 16th Street, the 8th Street corridor coming in from the east and coming from the north, which probably is the one that has the best look for the most part, coming in off of the Unity Bridge. Is that something that is maybe a luxury to consider, or is that something that maybe as the city tries to continue looking good, it needs to be addressed?
Well, I think it is addressed. I think the city does need to look at it. And I remember 20 years ago, I was on the Planning Commission and they were thinking of the entrance to the city from the east down 16th Street. You know, there's 20 years of planning that goes into that. And now it's curbed and it's a beautiful entrance with the center island and everything. So that gets established. It wasn't like, you know, we forget what it used to look like. And the same thing with coming from the north and around that curve on Old Chicago Drive to East Street. All that is in planning. It takes time. We're very conscious of it. We've had consultants and we have to work regionally. You're exactly right. And Keith is, of course he's correct in saying that those are township properties, but we work with the townships and we work with contiguous municipalities. So I do think that does, it's your impression when you first come into a town. So we have signage, we try to make it look as attractive as possible. And then it to be functional too, not just good looks.
Yeah, and the other thing too along those lines is the fact that some of the jewels of Holland has been freshened up and looking good. And one of them will be spotlighted on Sunday when Garrison Keillor comes to the Herring of Holland Civic Center place. Yes. 5-10 years ago, getting a performance like that there might be, you know, that old dingy place. Far different cry now.
I remember, yeah. And it, you know, we had that choice, tear it down or refurbish it. And it looks really nice and it works really well. Even the parking lot looks nice.
Nikki Arendshorst, the Holland City Council member, thank you very much for joining us this morning on WHTC's Morning News City Hall Chatter. Wish you and your family well for the Christmas season and look forward to chatting with you during 2022, I should say.
Yeah, it moves so fast, doesn't it?
Thank you. Sure does. Thank you very much, Nikki Arendshorst, on 99.7 and 1450 WHTC.